In this peaceful spot by the River Brent in West London, St. Mary's Perivale has stood for nearly 900 years. Surrounded by its peaceful churchyard, it has survived storms, wars, famines, plagues, and even developers. Acquired in 1976 by a charity set up for the purpose, it has now become one of the most important classical music venues in Britain. We're too small for orchestras, but our size and acoustics give us a perfect venue for chamber music and instrumental recitals. During the recent pandemic, we were not allowed to have a live audience, but we have not only survived, but actually thrived by live streaming our concerts. Now, we are thrilled to be able to readmit an audience, but the live streams continue as an essential part of our offering. So, wherever you are, enjoy this concert. And please consider donating via our website. Thank you very much indeed. Good afternoon and welcome to St. Mary's Perivale for a choral concert. Very unusual for us. We have very few vocal items, but today we have the Continuum Choir, Chamber Choir, conducted by Harry Guthrie. He'll tell you all about it. Basically, they're all wonderful choral scholars from Cambridge singing unaccompanied fare. I have to say that there were going to be 8 singers, but as happens with singers, 2 of them have gone down with a bug, so it's 6, but they're so good that won't matter, and Harry will explain all about that. The programme is as billed on our YouTube channel, and for those here in the audience, there's a long list of their anthems that they're going to sing. The only one that isn't going to be included is by Healy Willan, I Beheld Her as a Dove. That one is scrapped, so that's halfway through the programme. But without more ado, Harry Guthrie will explain about it all. I'd like you all to give a big round of applause to our singers. Thank you very much.
Good afternoon, everybody. I'm delighted to be here, both for those in the room and for those live on YouTube, to be performing at St. Mary's Perivale for the first time. As Hugh says, we've got a varied programme for you this afternoon, ranging from something in the late 15th century all the way up to something that was written just a few years ago. It is as a spanning of all of the centuries of British choral music and of both the sacred and the secular. As Hugh says, we're normally an ensemble that are made up of sopranos, altos, tenors and basses. This is giving us a chance today to look at what's called the lower voices repertoire that might be sung on that cold Tuesday evening in a cathedral that doesn't get pulled out too often, but some of it's rather good. And so it's quite nice to be unearthing it as a group together for the first time today. We're starting with one of the great men's voices anthems from the 20th century by William Henry Harris, Holy is the True Light.
For what wert thou?
That was Gerald Finzi's setting, Thou Didst Delight My Eyes, words by Robert Bridges. And it sort of shows off some of the sort of versatility that we're hoping to show this evening, with some numbers featuring some singers, some numbers featuring me taking a seat and letting them take it away. We're going to go back now a few hundred years, though, for you, and perhaps start to chart this story of Holy Week that so many buildings in the country are going to embark on in the next week. We start with Orlando Gibbons' O Lord, Rebuke Me Not, before moving to an earlier contemporary in Robert Parsons. It's a rather extraordinary piece, this Ave Maria. It ends with an expansive setting of an Amen that is perhaps, for me, more reminiscent of something written by Brahms. It's not particularly progressive in the techniques that it uses. It's not progressing the Renaissance period forward into the Baroque. It's sort of out of time for me. It's deeply romantic music, this. And we'll close this section of our Renaissance with Tallis' Lamentations, Part 1.
Oh, Lord.
Tallis' setting of O Nata Lux is one of the most performed anthems in the country, but we turn now to a different setting of this text by a contemporary composer, Piers Connor Kennedy, a friend of the group who has a very similar background to many of us, having been involved with the traditions of Wells Cathedral, St John's College, Cambridge, and currently Christ Church Cathedral in Oxford. His setting is in three parts and will be sung by just three of our singers. We follow that with a piece by James O'Donnell, Present Yourselves as a Living Sacrifice. James O'Donnell recently stepped down as organist and master of the choristers of Westminster Abbey, with one of his final engagements being to conduct the funeral of the late Queen Elizabeth II. He now hails in Yale in America, heading up their Institute for sacred music. We start with Piers Connors Kennedy's O Nata Lux, followed by James O'Donnell's Present Yourselves as a Living Sacrifice.
Yeah.
Moving back now from the 21st century into the 20th, we continue with two works that are precursors to this tradition. The first, Imogen Holst's setting of a hymn to Christ, stunning poetry by John Donne, set in a harmonic style that begins somewhere around an E, that sound reaches across a very short piece of two minutes into a transcendent key of B major at the end. And we follow that with Edward Elgar's great, great motet, They Are at Rest.
Put thou thy sin in it, waste my sin.
The latter half of our programme is almost solely diverted to the secular tradition of British music making. In the Renaissance period, the heyday of this was the madrigal, and we start with John Bennett's Weep, O Mine Eyes. We proceed this, we follow this rather, with a slightly earlier trio piece, Ah Robin, Gentle Robin, by William Cornysh. Perhaps the younger, perhaps William Cornysh the older. We will never know. And we succeed that with a lower voices arrangement by John Wilbye of Flora Gave Me Fairest Flowers.
We
Perhaps the spiritual successor to the madrigal was found 300 years later in the arrangements of British folk songs that were so popular in the 1920s, 30s, and 40s, and it's to that period we journey now with perhaps the most famous of the exponents of this in Ralph Vaughan Williams. Two arrangements now, the first of The Turtle Dove and the second of Bushes and Briars.
Farewell, my dear, I must be gone and leave you for my
The final piece in our programme this evening turns to Charles Villiers Stanford from his three motets written for the choir of Trinity College, Cambridge in the 1890s. This setting is rather like some of the Renaissance pieces we heard earlier, in that to me you can hear the secular influences. The texture is, for me, in six parts, with each part interwoven over the other. It's distinctly madrigalian for me, despite it being a secular text. We close our programme tonight with Stanford's Beati Quorum Vir.
Thank you.
We do have one final number for you this afternoon. Famed, perhaps, for writing operettas, he also wrote this rather stunning number for just voices. This is The Long Day Closes by Arthur Sullivan.
The long day closes.
Well, your applause says it all, but the musical and vocal skills to sing all that repertoire dead in tune, yeah. Making such a beautiful sound, dear me, it's staggering. I think they deserve another big round of applause. Yeah. And we have we'll get them back next year, by which time our two sops should have got over their sore throat. Is that right, Harry? Got a whole year to get them better. But anyway, thank you very much if you've been watching from afar. It looks superb this afternoon, really good, and had some compliments from all over the world. And it's... huge thanks to Rob Jenkins upstairs for doing the camera work and fixing the sound for the broadcasts. Huge thanks to my wife, Felicity, for doing box office. And thank you, everyone here in the church, for coming along for this slightly different concert. But it is the start of Holy Week. And carrying on that theme, on Good Friday afternoon at 4 o'clock, we have Haydn's Seven Last Words on the Cross, which, if you don't know, is a wonderful string quartet setting by Haydn of 8 movements. It's ravishingly beautiful, and interspersed there will be appropriate seasonal readings. That's 4 o'clock on Friday, piano recital on Tuesday, so the show goes on. Thank you very much for being with us at St. Mary's Perivale, and thank you, Continuing Choir and Harry Guthrie, for a fantastic afternoon. Thank you very much. With that, over and out from West London. See you next time. Thank you.